Welcome back to Let's Play Rome Total War House of Julii Campaign Epilogue Episode 8. And when we left off, we'd taken over the North African coastline from the Scipii, and we've left Phapsus now isolated and ready to take. So we're going to start making plans to take Phapsus very soon. I'm also moving towards Dimindi in order to capture that, and then we're going to move into the Sahara and just basically mop up the last of the Scipii's desert territories. So we are now two turns away from making our way to Dimindi, and then we'll have to build up our siege equipment, but that town should fall very, very easily. The same goes for Nepta. So after that, then we are going to push east and finish off the Scipii in Africa as they are now continuing their push into Egypt, where it looks like the Egyptians are fighting back with plenty of numerous forces, I guess, and they are making their way into Scipian territories again. So we might try and take back Libya, which would save me a bit of work, actually. So they are moving, they're using their captains, looks like they're not really using their generals. I'm not sure how many family members the Egyptians have, so. But that's not our problem. As long as the Egyptians make a good buffer against the Scipii and stop them from retreating, that's what I'm happy about. But we do need to focus now on the Brutii for a little bit. We've been weakening the Brutii, and ever since capturing Bizalara, we've basically opened up another way into Thessalonica, which has the Brutii very worried now. So they are sending some armies to counterattack me, but I'm sending more armies to stop them as well. I have Julianus Alenius, he's making his way now to attack the Brutii, but I am also ready to leave Vicus Goffi. So Appius Marcius and all of his men will now be leaving those peasants behind, because they're not worth coming. And he's going to be making his way to Domus Dulcis Domus in order to capture that town. If we capture Domus Dulcis Domus, we're going to start squeezing the Brutii from the north now. But also, I have personal reasons for taking Domus Dulcis Domus, because that was once my territory. It was the last territory I had to capture in order to eliminate the Germanians. So I feel it's only right that I control that territory once more, and then also get rid of the local Gepids. And then I'm not going to bother taking Themiscaria again, by the way. It's not worth it. I don't think we're going to have a chance of taking that ever again. But apart from that, we are in a very, very strong position now. So Vicus Goffi, before we do anything else, we are near the end of this turn as well, because we have done a lot of movements over the past few episodes with these turns. Not going to leave Vicus Marcomanni, by the way, just because I'm waiting for someone who's better than this idiot to lead it. So maybe if we get another family member soon, we can do that. But I am going to start recruiting a few more cohorts into this area, and then just a few auxilia, because I do need to have a stronger garrison here, because obviously this place is not exactly susceptible to Brutii attacks, but there is a risk factor involved. I know the Brutii are trying to make a move against Campus Lazicus again, though my army should be able to stop them. And I am currently building up at Porolisium, so we are improving the area, and we should be able to leave quite soon, actually. Very soon, actually. So you know what? I'm going to start recruiting some more auxilia at Porolisium, because I would like to leave ASAP and start making my way to Campus Getae or Campus Siphi, and then we can make moves against Tillis and Byzantium, which is still under the thumb of rebels, unfortunately. Meanwhile, at Corinth, we are done training men, actually, so. But I still have trouble getting spies into Athens, for Athens seems to be very, very spy-proof. I only have a 22% chance to infiltrate. So, spy, you're going to do a job for me. Spy on Captain Julianus and get some more experience, please. If you can do this, then I will have more trust in you. But he's already looking at you, so I'm assuming you've already fucked up. No, he didn't fuck up. Right, good. Captain Julianus is marching probably towards Larissa. He's bringing some legionaries, some Praetorians, some legionary cavalry. Basically, not a bad army, actually. A very somewhat decent army, so I should be wary of that. But that hasn't improved your chances of it infiltrating, right? What else could you do? I know you can't do multiple missions per turn, so you know what? Just stay in the area and get ready to do more things for me, but just move away, just so you're not in the way, please. Assassin, he's done his move this turn. He's currently chasing down, actually, have you moved this turn? I don't think you have. No, you haven't, right? You're two turns away from catching up with Vibius Munisanius and killing him, so you just keep moving towards him. If you track him down and kill him, I will be very happy, because that'll be another Brutii family member out of the way. So we do need to get ready to attack Thessalonica now. I'm rebuilding Apollonia. Before, we did try to take Thessalonica a few episodes ago, but that all went a bit wrong when the Brutii launched a massive counterattack against me and just basically threw everything at me. Larissa, though, we are nearly done. We are just waiting for a unit of legionary cavalry, and then now I'm going to throw in one more unit of archer auxilia, because I said so. But I'm also doing some retraining, it looks like, because I'm assuming we also just unlocked the next level of armor and stuff, so we may as well get that over and done with. So Corinth. I don't have spies in Athens, which annoys me because I do need to know what is in Athens. But I do have a lot of infantry to bring. So I'm actually going to just take all my lower level infantry here. I'm going to take the urbans. I'm going to take the legionaries. And then I'll take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 early legionary cohorts. That should be enough men. You guys, lay siege to... Oh, fuck's sake. Corinth. Why do you get angry whenever I send anything away? Right. Corinth is a bloody whiny bitch city, isn't it? Right. I'm going to train more men at Corinth just to make up the slack. But either way, I want to get rid of Athens now because I'm sick of looking at Athens. So, get a siege tower over and done with, please. And then we can attack this area. Actually, no. Don't bother with siege. Let's go for sapping, actually. 1 sapping point should do. Yeah, 1. No, 2 sapping points, actually. That'll keep the Brutii on their toes. Right. Corinth, because you're a bloody whining bitch of a city, what can we build to make you happy? City plumbing, that'll get rid of squalor. Circus Maximus, that'll give you happiness. Right, there we go. Done. And also recruit some auxilia just to keep the peace. Right, there we go. Done. Right, anything else we can do then this turn? Well, not really, because I've spent all the money now. So we are going to jump to the next turn now, and then we're going to see what else is going to happen, because I'm not making any more movements against the Brutii just yet, because I just want to keep an eye on them, if you know what I mean. But for now, let's go to the next turn and see what happens, because I also want to see what the Scipii are going to do. They're probably not going to be very happy that I've now, this turn, taken 2 more provinces off them, which is now brought them down to their last 5 provinces. So they are now in very, very, very dangerous waters. Let's go. Right. Of course I'd get counterattacked, and it's a place where I don't want it. So Julianus does bring his force to stop me now, which means I do also now have to fight the... Oh, wait, we're fighting Julianus and Julianus. Great! So we are fighting 2 armies at once now, unfortunately. But I do have 3 urban cohorts in this army, which does make me a little bit happier, because I do know urban cohorts are very good. They can get overwhelmed, we know, but... We do know that Captain Julianus does have cavalry, which could make life a bit hectic for me. But then again, he doesn't have a lot. So we might be able to stop him. He does have cavalry auxilia, however, but we do know they do run out of javelins quite quickly, which is good. Need to be careful of his ballistas, though. But apart from that, I'm not going to say we're going to win this battle, but I am going to say we might just pull through. So strength ratio is 1 to 2 in the enemy's favour, so... We are going to have to fight the odds here, because I am outnumbered by quite a lot, actually. He has about nearly 600 men. I only have 414. It's going to be a close one, my friends, but either way, I'm looking forward to this. Win this battle, my captain, and then you will get reinforcements for your attack on Athens. That's how it's going to go. Good. I don't think we take Athens with this battle, but we might get close. Today we face those sorry, captains, don't make speeches. I'm sorry, even if it is this situation. My captain has very smartly, though, chosen to attack with a urban cohort unit. He's with the urbans, so his life shouldn't be too much of a concern for me. But I think we will be facing an attack from here, of course. And let's play spot Athens now. Where is Athens? God, this is a shitty part of Greece, by the way, I have to say. Very, very uncolourful. I can't see Athens anywhere, but I do see a road, which gives me a clue where Athens is. Athens is either on the top of that hill, or it's down here, but I can't see it. So I suspect... Oh, look at that. There's one of those funny road junctions over there, actually. That's an odd junction there. It's like, I guess we're planning to build a truck stop or something. But then there's another road snaking off over here, actually. So I suspect Athens is somewhere in this region of the battlefield here, so... We are going to basically get attacked from one direction, so what are we going to do? Well, Earlies are going to make the front line because that's how it's going to have to go. Legionaries will make the centre line and urbans will make the core. It's not the strongest defence, but unfortunately my options are limited. However, just to counter the enemy baluster, which will be inevitably aiming for my urban cohort. Urban cohorts, you will be the core. You'll be firing at will, or at least you won't be firing at will, because you are going to be in Test Tudor formation, the famous Test Tudor formation, the tortoise shell. This will make them immune, well, not immune, but this will make them much harder to hit with arrows, and it might be able to provide extra defense against ballistas. So, and it might make them harder to hit, actually, they're a smaller target, not a big spread out target that the artillery needs to hit, so that might provide me with a bit of a strong defense. And I'm going to have legionary cohorts, they're going to be the flank. I'm going to put them on diagonal flanks just to try and afford extra protection for the urban cohorts who are just in a nice Test Tudor formation to provide extra defense. Everyone will be firing at will except the urban cohorts, who can't fire at will because they're in Test Tudor. They will break Test Tudor as soon as I see fit, by the way. But apart from that, let's try and hold out, I guess.
The enemy have brought up reinforcements in a pathetic attempt to save themselves.
Athens was on top of a hill barrier. So what is the Athenian army made up of? Legionaries, auxilia, Praetorians. That's the scary part, actually. Quite a few, three units of Praetorians, actually. Oh dear. However, just to ruin everything, they have equites. Well done. Oh, is that cavalry auxilia? No, it's cavalry auxilia, right? So it's not equites. So didn't ruin everything. Well, sort of ruined everything. Then some earlies and some gladiators. So yeah. That's actually not a bad army. It's actually an army that could stop me. Yeah. The Brutii have decided to up their game, it looks like, in these last hours of the war. They've realised that they are losing and must bring better units in order to stop me. So they are bringing stronger units. Right, my front line isn't going to hold then. It is not going to hold, not one bit, because it is weak. Right. Urban cohorts, break Test Tudor. It's not worth being in Test Tudor. Fire at will as well. I don't think the cavalry auxilia will provide too much damage against you anyway. I think you guys should be able to sponge the enemy fire. Where is that baluster, by the way, is it? They're preparing their baluster. Still moving it, right. We'll just have to tank baluster fire, unfortunately. You know, because it isn't worth doing anything against the baluster. We'll just have to tank its fire. There's only one of them. It shouldn't provide too much damage. But one advantage we do have, I think it looks like the army of Captain Julianus, the aggressor, should reach us first. The Athenian army is taking its time. It looks like they're just messing around at the minute, trying to work out what their formation is going to be. Cavalry auxilia, it looks like it's trying to go on the flank, or it's riding away. I think they're going to try and flank us with the auxilia cavalry, but it isn't really too much of an issue for me because it's only cavalry auxilia. It is weak. It will just try and hurt us with a few javelins, but apart from that, they won't be much stronger than one unit of equites in hand-to-hand combat, so we don't need to worry too much about them. What I do need to worry about is the Praetorian cohorts, and once more the Brutii have decided to go back to their standard tactic of one big battle line. However, it's not even moving, so that makes me wonder what the Brutii are up to. Because not their artillery isn't even firing. Are they just going to initiate the attack with cavalry? I suspect so. It's actually the same as going for that Brutii over there. They are trying to send all the cavalry onto my flanks. Right, urban cohort, you've got an important task now. Turn around, face backwards. There we go. Right, I don't want you to get hit in the back, that's all. So you guys will just be making a rear flank now. So it's a shame I don't have a general or something to squash in the middle, but it doesn't matter. Right, so I'm defended because it's just two main lines which are coming up against me. So actually, legionary cohorts, I want you to just open your line out a little bit and face this way. I'm not moving the early line, by the way, because that's the line that's most vulnerable. But cavalry auxilia have now decided to just plant themselves there. I think they're getting ready to do some pelting. Oop, dear, I zoomed too far. I think they are going to try and pelt us, or yeah, they're just moving in closer. I don't think these guys have a brilliant range, because once more, cavalry archery is just not the thing that the Romans were good at. Really wasn't. It was the thing that ended up killing them, actually, so well done, cavalry archers. But I am getting a few of my javelins in there, so we are exchanging fire, and they are just panicking. Ah, wait, they're going to form a Cantabrian circle, actually. So they're going to throw their javelins, they're just going to expire them. My guys are retaliating with a few javelins of their own. But it looks like they're not very accurate, which is good for me at least. Right, you guys just quickly ungroup. Just stretch your formation out a little bit, please, just so we're a little bit more secure. And then group back up, right. We are exchanging a few more pilums with these. I think they're trying to make me waste my pilums, actually, but you know what? I killed one of their cavalry oxidators, so it's not a waste of pilums. These guys shouldn't have too many left. Good volley there, my friends. Good volley. My urban cohorts are now getting their pilums in to add to the hurt. But now the enemy is just waiting. They are waiting for their opportunity to do their moves. But I'm seeing quite a lot of dead cavalry, and we've broken it, right? Cavalry auxilia's gone, right? That might piss this army off now. It might start advancing. It is, right. So they were just going to go for initial missile attrition and then make their main move. The Athenian army is now practically on top of me, though. You guys are about to get fucked because, yeah, I'm sorry. You guys are not in a good position. You are in for the world of hurt, but please try to live. And, hey, you got a few pilums into the enemy, so you know what? You did good. Velite gladiators are coming in. It's all right. Velite gladiators, as we've seen, they do tend to last long in terms of morale, but in terms of being alive, they don't last. Oh, damn it. Fuck's sake. That guy's routed. Damn it, that's just opened my line up, right? Fucking hell, you guys. You guys are so disbanded when I get back to the campaign map. Right. Change of plan. Urban cohorts, we need you to now get into a support role. We're going to have to ignore that cavalry oxygen. I don't want to ignore the enemy that is currently just walking around on my flanks thinking, ooh, which unit am I going to pick on today? But unfortunately, it's come to that, right? Urban cohorts, you're going to have to become my rear line now. You'll provide support to... You want to provide support. You guys, legionary cohorts, you are dealing with Praetorian cohorts. Urban cohorts, you will provide support to them because, as you know, urban cohorts, you pull around the edge, you're going to get on the flanks. I've got an idea. Urban cohorts as well, you have to deal with those Praetorians. They're trying to sneak around my flanks, so you guys will stop the flank attack. You guys are going to be my flank attack. We are going to try and sneak into the enemy flanks. Early cohorts, try to hold out for as long as possible. I know some of you are routing. Some of them have reformed, however. Good, they've reformed. Right, you are being chased down by Velite gladiators, but getting them and kill them. You guys are doing a good job, just sneaking around the flank. Keep it up. We're going to get around the back of those Praetorians and give their asses a good kicking, right? 3, 2, 1, get in their backs! Good. Get in the back of those Praetorians and give them what for now. Nice one, urban cohorts. That's what I like to see. Right in their back. We're not going to win this battle. I'm going to tell you that now. We are not winning this battle, but you know what? More of their high-tier units I take out, the more hurt I do to them long-term. That gives me a better chance to put up a better attack against Athens and against Thessalonica. But my general's nerve is annoyingly broken. He's only a captain. I would have expected him to flee. He's a thoroughbred general like I would have liked, and I've lost. Fuck.
So many good Romans have died for no purpose. But from this, victory will spring afresh.
Well, that's the last time I attack Athens. Nah, I'm just kidding. I'm attacking Athens again. Yep, I did lose. But you know what? I took 154 men out, though I'm left with very little. So we need to get back to Corinth now and replenish. That's annoying. But I guess some of my guys really did try. The urban cohorts especially, they really did try. But unfortunately, without enough support, they did perish. Actually, you know what, looking at what the Athenian army was as well, I think we might actually would have lost in the siege. So, you know what, this was a warning to me. So, I do need to bring a better army to Athens, which I will do. And here's a shit naval battle. It's going to be the one, it's the one that's on the way to Cyrene, by the way. Great, it would get intercepted. Don't lose! Oh, you won. Good. Victory! And luckily the Scipii didn't attack us. Right. Well, that was one military disaster done, but we do have other things to deal with. So it looks like my units have retreated back to Corinth. That's where I want them to be. So right, first things first, Auxilia, let's stop training you. Get you guys retrained and get ready for round two. Not letting the Brutii just sit around on a victory like that. Because now they're just infesting my territory, but they've left Thessalonica very weak now. Which might be my opportunity to strike. But first and foremost, end of turn report. Minimal losses. Still, I still have nearly 50,000 now. City has expanded. Ooh, Tara. Ooh, wow. Not heard from you in a long time, Tara. Well, you may have your expansion. You may also have highways. You may also have crop rotation. Wait, why am I giving you highways? You don't need highways. Nah, just kidding. Have some highways. You may also have a better temple. And just because I'm feeling generous, better public baths. All the nice amenities Tara needs. Right, good. Right, other things to do with faction announcements. Secundus the Gambler died. He was governor of Narbo Marches. That was tragic, but unfortunately he had to die. Well, he didn't have to die, but old age happens, I guess. Limonum is rioting, by the way. You need to be back in Limonum, Aulus. Get back to Limonum now, because I'm not having Limonum riot and then rebel, because... What, did they get really angry that I took out the rebels? Were they, like, best mates or something? Nah, right. Limonum's better. Domitia has been born, by the way. Valerius Mamilius has a pontifex. Lentulus Salvadenius has a drinking companion. And Caius Pompeius, a silk merchant. Cool. Right, other things. Construction report, Mediolanum Mercuria, Carthago Nova, a better temple, a quincum for Proconsul's Palace, Campus Lazicus, the barracks, and Lilibeum, a urban barracks, right? A quincum and Campus Lazicus are the ones I want to focus on. So first things first, a quincum. You now have the next level of building, so what could we give a quincum? Give him a great forum, give him better irrigation and a better barracks. Good. Right, that's that area sorted out nicely. And next up, Campus Lenticus. Looks like the Brutii aren't going to bother sieging you. They might attack Porolysium though, so that delays me leaving Porolysium for now. But we've got the barracks up, right? Next thing's Militia Barracks. Get that worked on. Also get the irrigation worked on and a Temple of Jupiter. I know Guy's Victor's time is running out. I know he's going to die soon, but unfortunately, I just need to improve Campus Lenticus because the Brutii just left his town in an absolute trash state. I'm also very conscious about leaving Bizalora, by the way. I do know there's still quite a few Brutii running around this area, so we just need to try and keep... I think what we need to do is, like we have done with the Scipia, we need to have a session of just sniping out some enemy armies. But we do have Auxilia from Segesta, Lugnum some Auxilia, Luvavum some Auxilia, Capua some Praetorian Cavalry, Vicus Goffi some early legionary cohorts, Parma some Auxilia, Tarentum some urban cohorts, Rome some Praetorian cohorts, Apollonian some early legionary cohorts, Condate Redonum some triremes, Syracuse some auxilia, Corinth some auxilia, Lilibeum some auxilia, Porolysium some auxilia, and then blah 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 blah. Right, let's get on with all our other stuff then. So first, Navy, keep on moving towards Cyrene. Try to avoid getting killed by the Brutii, please. I will actually send one of my stronger navies, Admiral Secundus. You will go there. You will try to intercept the Brutii if they attack you. Admiral Quintus, you keep making your way to Cyrene. There we go. Right. Hopefully this navy here will cover this navy here. I don't know if it'll work, but it might work. It might give the Brutii some bait. And then you start making your way to Cyrene. You know where to go. We're going to dock there in 2 turns' time. The local army... Oh, look at that, by the way. Local army is wandering off, so they're leaving Cyrene nice and undefended for me. Perfect. Right, spy. How are we doing with you? Tiberius Classicus. Can you make it to Siwa now? You have a 100% chance of spying on Siwa, but I still can't give you a move. I guess it's because we don't know all the roads in the area or something, so you still need to plot out where they all are. Well, we're going to show you where all the roads are, because you're going to keep making your way there. So get down there and get ready to do some spying, please. So down. Follow the nice roads along the African coast. It must be a lovely view there, I hope. Right, keep on moving. We're getting close. I think we'll make it to Siwa very, very soon. And soon I'll be visiting Siwa with an army and destroying it. I'll probably use the army here, which match with Admiral Quintus. We could probably take Cyrene very easily, and then we could just match directly to Siwa, and then that's basically going to be the Scipii dealt with very, very shortly from now. Right, also with the Scipii, let's keep matching on Gaetulius. So how close are we now? 2 turns away from Dimindi, good, and then that's everything I've dealt with. Right. That's the Scipii under control for now. Cirta is rioting annoyingly, so we need to deal with Cirta. Let's start retraining a few more troops, first things first, and then move the shrine up to priority placement. Actually, we need a shrine being built now. And actually, as an added bonus, I'm going to have the Emperor himself govern the area. How long would it take the Emperor to reach the area? 2 turns. Right. Emperor, there's room for you there. So Emperor Publius, you all have to use your governing skills and monitor Cirta for now. I know it's something of a menial task, but unfortunately it has to be done, and you would be the best person for the job. You are the Emperor. You bring an aura of authority with you, so make sure Cirta grows properly and grows safely, for I will also be leaving Carthage soon to make my attack, right? And while we're here at Carthage, I'm making sure you don't auto-manage anything, because I know you would try and build something I would not have authority for you to build. And meanwhile, over here, by the way, Tingi's doing alright. Good! Right. Other thing to deal with quickly, where is my boat here, which is nearby? I see. Admiral Quintus, right. Drop. Oh, come on. 2 turns again. I just have to see that little red nub and it ruins my day. Right, come on, drop him off. Drop him off. Oh, for fuck's sake. Why can't I ever drop anything off within one turn? Why does it always have to be like a turn and a bit with me? Fucking hell, right. I'll have to deal with that in a minute because, right, I've got an idiot who can't get off boats properly. He's going to be a fine governor of anything if he doesn't know how to get off a simple fucking boat, right. Other things to deal with, right. We need to deal with the Brutii a little bit more. Let's see what's going on in the north first. We'll start from the north and work down south, right. So, army here. So, how are we doing, Appius Marcius? Two turns away from Domus Dulcis. Domus, the Brutii already have an army ready to stop me. I don't care. We'll attack the army, then we'll take out the garrison of Domus Dulcis. Domus probably should have actually attacked the army now this turn, but oh well, he'll attack me anyway, then I'll just take him out on a defensive formation. I have plenty of light auxilia, plenty of archer auxilia. I could take him out on a defensive, so I don't care. Right, other armies, right. Julianus, you are currently chasing down Caius Clodius. He's wandering off, but we are still close by. So you know what? Keep trying to move to intercept him. Because we do need to intercept and kill more Brutii armies in order to just clear the area and then make these cities even more vulnerable. That is what we should do against Brutii. It's something I haven't been doing, but it's now something I'm going to try and do. Porolisium, we're still growing here. Camp Slazagus, we're still doing stuff here. Right, Bizalara, how are we doing here? Well, we are pretty much ready to start moving on Thessalonica, which I would rather do. But I do know there is Brutii military presence up here in the form of this person here, Captain Secundus. We don't know what he has. Spy, where are you? Another chance for you to get more experience. Make your way north, find out what the Brutii are doing up there. Down here, we do have a lot of Brutii military to deal with. So you know what? Before we attack Thessalonica from Larissa like I was originally planning, I'm going to start taking out these Brutii armies here on the coast. Then we're going to have Athens vulnerable, and then Athens should fall again properly this time. So let's select Larissa. How are we doing over here? We are still recruiting. We are still retraining as well, so fuck it. We're going to have to put that idea off for another time. So I want to make sure my men are upgraded before we move. I'd rather have upgraded men than unupgraded men, because that gives me just a little extra boost against the enemy. So there actually isn't a lot I can do against the Brutii right now, apart from just keep on moving, so which is what I'm doing. So, I don't know. Segestica, you win the lottery for today. I've decided to select you at random and build you a forum and an academy. There you go. Enjoy it. Don't blow all your money at once. Salona, anything we could do here? Not really. Aquincum, I've already paid attention to you very recently. Levavum, Decimus Julius is, yeah. So you know what? Levavum, you get extra attention paid to you. So, temples, forums, public baths. Public bath, yeah, there you go, build that public bath. An academy, for he will be raising his fine family here, and arena, there we go, everything built, all the money spent, and I can go to the next turn, because there isn't really a lot to do this turn. So, next turn, please, let's see what the Brutii are up to now, because they're probably going to be planning something to fuck me up, like they always do. Oh, we've been ambushed, apparently. Oh, no, I ambushed the enemy. Oh, Caius Clodius, have you not learnt not to go through forests? I have ambushed an army of a Brutii faction, and they didn't know I was coming. They will have no time to prepare, which means I can prepare, and they will be caught out, basically. So I get to arrange my ambush, and I get to kill the enemy. Perfect! Oh, that's just put a smile on my face. We can get rid of another enemy. And by the way, did that general die down here? I didn't really see if my assassin did the job properly. Did he? Where are we? It was about here, wasn't it? Near Tillis. No, he didn't do it properly. Oh, well. I don't care because I've got an ambush to deal with. So, Julianus Alenius and his 793 men are now going to ambush Caius Clodius and his 351 men. Strength ratio is 10 to 1 because I have a bonus from a successful ambush. I have plenty of early legionary cohorts, plenty of archer auxilia. Archer auxilia are going to do so well in this ambush, actually. I can hide them and then use them for an attack. This is perfect timing, because Caius Claudius' army is actually, well, it should really be called Caius the Clod, because Velater Gladiatus, Undermanned Auxilia, Principate, Hastati, a few earlies, a mix of archers. He does have siege equipment though, so that'll be fun to take out. So yeah, he has an underfunded and unmanned army, so let's take it out and then clear up the path to Vicus Venedae, because you know what, if we do this, I have a good feeling that we could take Venedae, because right now the Brutii are scrambling to defend Domus Dulcis Domus Aurum. They might be abandoning Domus Dulcis Domus. Silly, silly Brutii. Oh well, let's just take this army out now. Get rid of another Brutii idiot. Oh, this is going to be good. A perfect ambush. But why did this idiot stray from the road? Is Caius the Clod really as Clod? He is. He strayed from the road. Why? Why did he do that? What an idiot.
Units, await my orders!
Right, so we have this guy surrounded, basically, and we need to get ready to do our ambush. He doesn't know the attack is coming, boy. Wait, hang on. Just before we do... Have you noticed how did he not see me coming, actually? We are in we're not even in a forest, we're just on plains. Did he just see the my army and think it was just an unusual amount of farmers or something? Was that it? Wow, you really are blind, but yeah. As you can see, this is a perfect position for us. He's marching in a big straight line. He doesn't have time to make a formation. He doesn't have time to get fancy. But then again, this is what we call the average Brutii battle line anyway. So he has his stronger units towards the front, as I can see, and then he's just got himself at the front. So this is a good chance to wipe out the general, but I can attack him from two sides and sandwich him. So first things first, Archer Auxilia, they are going to be one of my primary attacking forces, and I'm going to have them just attack from... Well, I have two, but I'm just going to have them attack them from one angle just for the sake of simplicity. So they're going to deploy here, and then they're just basically going to have to take their pick on what they want to kill. But I'm going to probably have them target these Light Auxilia. These will be the best guys for me to attack. Now, as for the cavalry, I know there is some cavalry, so... What we're going to do is, Auxilia, you're going to be attacking the cavalry, which is at the front, so have fun killing the enemy general, so I'll make you guys into one group, and then, let's see, he has more cavalry towards the back as well, so I'm going to take out that cavalry with the rest of the Auxilia, so rest of the Auxilia, you're going to take out the rest of the cavalry, please. So, actually, I'm going to have my Auxilia swap around, because I'm going to have more on the general than on the... on the thing, but right, I'm just trying to get you guys to deploy. It might help if I face this way, actually, so then I could deploy people facing the right way around. So you guys deploy here, and then I'm just going to quickly move you across. So you guys go where these guys should be, and then you guys just, when I have you selected again, you guys will go here. What a perfect ambush this is, by the way. What an idiot army we're fighting against, right? So you guys are there, and now this is where the beauty comes in. So let's get some of the legionary cohorts here, and they're going to be firing at will. I don't think they'll be in pillum range, but I'll have them just basically charge in. We'll have them charge home against the enemy infantry and just wipe them all out here. So there we go, and we can also capture the enemy artillery, which is the other beauty in this plan. And then we'll have the rest of the cohorts just attack the main battle line from the rear. So actually, no, we'll have them attack this bit of a battle line here, which hasn't really got much pressure being put on against it right now. So let's just quickly get you guys deployed, and then we're ready. This is a very well-fought ambush, isn't it? I'm taking all this time to deploy, and he's just stood there frozen in time, realizing he's fucked up. Right, there we go. There we go. You're surrounded, you're ambushed, and you're fucked now. So it was nice knowing you, Caius the Clod, but... You dropped the ball on this one, not noticing my army just standing here on movements in the middle of this land with grass that is maybe a few inches tall, but there's nowhere really for me to hide anyway, so how did you just not spot me? Morons. Right, start the battle. Right, we don't have time to waste. Everyone get into line, get into battle, get this over and done with, because he is going to be scrambling to try and save his ass. So you guys need to get to work now. Get to work. He's sending his start. He's sending everything to try and stop me, but we need to just move in. We need to ambush him. Right, big block of legionaries here. Start moving against his main battle line. Enemy general has, as usual, decided to run off. He's obviously got become a big coward. Archer Auxilia, you guys are just being run at, but try and target the Velater Gladiators. General, I don't want you getting killed by Velater Gladiators. I'm sorry I ignored you for a few seconds there. Right, early to recourse, the general is yours, he's up and he's thrown himself into battle. You guys get in there and throw him. Jesus Christ, this ambush has already gone into chaos, hasn't it? Right, Auxilia, try and get in there. I was trying to fight this ambush out very... Oh, wait, I'm winning, actually. My big lump of men is actually now winning, right? Sorry, I was just thinking for a minute I was losing, but no, it turns out I'm absolutely crushing the enemy because I've captured their onagers and just made sure they fall silent now. Right, you guys get in there. The enemy just doesn't have any idea what it's doing. It's trying to scramble. It's trying to work out what to do. General, don't let him run away and start causing chaos among my archers. I don't like it when that happens. I don't like having dead archers. That really pisses me off. There we go. Get in there and stop him. Thank you. Right, he's routing. See that he dies.
Enemy general with fear. Now he flees the field like right. A coward.
Archers, target their archers. Exchange a few volleys. My units, start moving towards the enemy archers. We need to get them killed. Right, the gladiators are now good as dead. You guys, start moving towards the rest of the infantry. Start bringing them down. Start just bringing everything down, actually, because the enemy is now in just full retreat. They don't have a hope in the world. They've realized they're fucked up. Because they're not very good at spotting ambushes, unfortunately. Right, you got... you've caught him. Good, right. Get rid of him. Thank
Great
you very much.
God, be praised. The enemy general
this
is
ambush
killed.
Is now a 100% success. He
hearts.
Is dead. I have captured an enemy general. I have killed an enemy general. Couldn't have gone any better, really. And you know what? I don't think I've even taken... I've lost a few auxilia, but apart from that, my losses were actually pretty much nothing. Perfect! What a brilliant opportunity which was handed to me by the idiot Brutii. I am happy about this. I don't even care about poor Elysium's under siege. I know the Brutii will just give up and break it in like one turn time anyway, because that's what the Brutii are like. So everything's looking up for me. Everything is looking up. I think now we've killed this army off, I will now just start making my way to Vicus Venedae, because why not? And I don't know if that Light Auxilia is just retreating or it's just running away from my guys, because they're really, really scared. So cavalry, you need to be... you guys, turn around and deal with that Light Auxilia. May as well deal with them while they're available for you to deal with. Right, who's over here, by the way? What are these guys? I don't know what they are, because I'm not... Ah, they're principes. Right, go and kill them. Your Auxilia, they're principes. You could easily capture them. We've got these guys on the run, basically. Thank you. Right, finish them off. Let's finish everything off.
And drive them from the battlefield.
Wrap it all up with a nice big bow and make sure that the enemies will never be able to see another fall of snow. Right, you get... Oh, don't let them just run past you. Silly Billy, right. Capture those Roman archers. They should be got... They should have died, like, hundreds of years ago. Why are we still seeing pre-marine units being used by the Brutii? That's the Scipii's job, you idiot. It's the Scipii who bring crappy, outdated units to the battlefield. Not the Brutii, but, oh well, it doesn't matter. Either way, I've just slaughtered a big bunch of them, so hopefully we won't be seeing them again. I think we might be able to get this army wiped out of the campaign map now. Right, chase down what's left, what's left, what's left. Pretty much nothing now. They're Brutii out of here. There we go, he's dead. Yep, just one unit to go, and it's just this guy, right. Where's my general? General. Go give my guys a hand, please. Go kill it, it's just some Light Auxilia. You guys, get in there. Go on. You're in perfect intercept position. Go for the intercept. Oh, the god, they're fucking up. They fucked it up, haven't they? Oh, come on! How did you bugger up intercepting those guys? That was an awful turning circle being demonstrated by my units there. Need to make your turning circle narrower and less stupid and less slow.
Rome demands victory from her generals, and this day is clearly our victory!
Oh, well, the ambush was still a success. I basically brutally murdered an enemy army and killed their general and brought him down to 29 men. So, goodbye, Caius Clodius. I chased you down, then you just ran into me in an ambush. What an absolute idiot. So well done all my troops who really contributed quite well. No experience gained, sadly, but losses were quite minimal. I only lost 125 men. Good. Alright, it's not good to lose men, of course, but I didn't lose that many, so it was a good ambush overall. Valor is superior to numbers.
Victory!
And that's the end of that turn. Right. So, let's see, let's do this turn as well, my friends, because now we are in an even stronger position. So, Tiberius Julius, first things first, you will make your way to Dimindi and begin the siege. I hope you capture Dimindi very, very quickly, but you will only capture it next turn, so you'll be for next episode, but have fun taking this town. Let's see, what could we give you? Sapping points? Yeah, we'll go for sapping points. I just want to do sapping points, because this is an army with cavalry, and that's a town with absolutely nothing, so two sapping points, please, and have fun. Right, enemy army routes, by the way. Yep, the Caius Clodius' army is gone, so well done. You earned that victory there, dude. Did you get trait increases for that, by the way? I mean, we'll look in a minute, actually, but I hope you did. Still rolling in the cash. City has grown. Right, Corralis. You finally grew. Right, good for you, Corralis. Have your Imperial Palace and enjoy it. You also get an aqueduct in the Temple of Bacchus as an extra bonus, so enjoy. Right, who else? Oh, City expands as well. Oh, wow, we're getting big in Britannia, aren't we? Right, Dave, you get yours, and you also get a blacksmith as your bonus. Right, enjoy. And now, let's also get through other things. Most advanced faction, gone back to me, thank you very much. Faction announcement, Servius Lucilius has been born. Lucius Maxentius has a mistress, Lentulus Salvadens a treasurer, and games were held in Lepsis Magna. No trait increases for Julianus, which I don't find very good. That is a shame. I thought he would have got one for his good assassination. I mean, yeah, that honestly does feel like a bit of a shame. He should have got a trait increase just for that. Anyway, you start sieging Vicus Venedae, and I know the Brutii will once more get in a flap and start counterattacking. That's what I want them to do. You have a good army, Julianus. You do have a good army. We could fight them on the defensive, and it will probably keep breaking down the garrison to the point where we could easily go in. Plus, the walls are wooden, so with a few battering rams, we'd be in this town very easily. So, once more, the Brutii never learn. So, free battering rams should do. Have fun, settlement right? Construction siege, report, sir. By the way, before we do anything else. Lavavum, some highways, Batavadorum, some cavalry stables, Cydonia, crop rotation, Samara Breather, from Salona to the Proconsul's Palace, Lavosca, a stone wall, Byzalora, a trader, and Serta, the shrine. Right, so Salona, Byzalora, and Serta, I want to pay attention to right now. Salona has upgraded, so we'll give it an aqueduct, we'll give it a better forum, and we'll also give some irrigation and a better port. Cool. Right, now, Byzalora, you've just got your trader up, so start working on a market, a temple, and a sewers. Thank you very much. And then, last but not least, Serta, you've got your shrine up, start working on a temple, prioritize the temple, though, because we need to get that in. Publius, by the way, Emperor Publius, you get in there and help this town grow. You are an emperor. You'll be the emperor known as a great builder. That's what you shall be, right? And also make the games more frequent. You know, you gotta learn how to make the people love you. That's what you gotta do, emperor. You gotta make the people love the emperor. That's the key to being a strong emperor. Right, and also recruitment reports. Augustus March, Auxilia, Lugnum some Auxilia, Luvavum some Auxilia, Vicus Goffi some Elegy cohort, Bahamas some Auxilia. Keep going down the list. Light Auxilia from Asturica, Apollinia, some legionary cohort, Praetorian cohorts from Croton, Condate Redonum, another trireme, Larissa, some legionary cavalry, Auxilia from Porolysium, then we enter the retraining zone. Right! Well, there isn't a lot we can do with Scipii right now, because we're just currently making our way to Gaetulia and continuing that siege, and then it's going to be Nectar, and then we're going to get ready for the final push on Phapsus, and then Libya. So, what else can we do? Well, first and foremost, naval situation is quite good. We've managed to get Admiral Quintus home free. He should now be able to reach Cyrene safely within 2 turns. So you will dock at Cyrene, and then we will unload your troops, and then we will very quickly capture a city. Admiral Secunda, since you are my strongest navy in the Mediterranean, let's just clean up some Brutii and get rid of him. So there we go, clear victory. I hope he's... Does he sink? Good, he's sunk. Right. Make your way to Admiral Lentulus and get rid of him. May as well just start taking control of the seas again, because we have let the Brutii get away with this for too long. I do have my growing navy here now as well, so we'll be getting rid of all these barbarian pirates, which have turned up very, very soon. So it'll be a nice thing to clean them up. Right, so anyway, let's jump to the north now once more. This is where the action's taking place today. So the Brutii are bringing troops into Domus Dulcis Domus. We're not quite committed to attacking or defending right now, so I'm going to give them the incentive to start their counterattack, which would probably hand this town over on a platter for me and just get the siege underway. So time to get this town back. And they haven't upgraded the defences ever since I left it, by the way, so that's already a poor sporting show from then. I mean, alright, the town might not have grown, fair enough, but the Brutii just do not seem to care for the settlements they capture. They just adopt their culture and just go as a crow flies. They shouldn't be doing that. They need to enforce Roman stuff on it. That's what you gotta do. But right, that's 2 Brutii settlements under siege for the one I'm being sieged at, so I'm already got the advantage there. Porolysium is under siege. We're gonna win that battle. I don't care. We're gonna win, guaranteed. Assassin Vibius Mancinius is on his way there to try and help out as well. See that he doesn't arrive, please. It's a 1 in 5 chance, I know, but sometimes we do get lucky, and I've gotta just keep on trying to get lucky. Yes, I probably should have had him practice on a captain, but I'm too cocky for that shit. I think that captain's trying to block the bridge, by the way, to block some trade. Not really affecting me too much, so I'm not going to be too fussed about that. Right, I hope you kill this guy, dude, because I would be very happy if you did. Ah, you didn't do it. That's a shame. Oh, well. You missed, but did you elude the guards? Yeah, he eluded the guards. Good, 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 good. Right. Other things to do then. So, what is the situation with Tillis and Thessalonica and all that shit? What are we going to be doing against about the Brutii here? Well, first things first, you go and deal with Captain Tertius. See what he's up to, because that's going to keep on giving you experience. Some rebels have turned up in a local area, but they had a problem with Thessalonica, so that means the Brutii are losing control of their own territories again. So, well done, Brutii, for being silly, silly sausages. Now, other things to deal with quickly. What's the deal with Larissa now? How are we doing? We're still recruiting one last unit of Archerox here. We also got one unit to retrain. Right, so we can leave Larissa next turn. Corinth. We're retrained at Corinth now. But I don't want to have a Corinth army alone make the moves, because Athens is still well defended, which is annoying. I think the Brutii have actually just consolidated their defences now and put all their armies into Athens. So I could just empty the Corinth garrison and attack with that, which probably would work. The only thing is, Corinth is not a stable city, and I can't risk leaving it, because it'd probably riot or something, but I am adding some extra construction to the queue in order to make it happier. So I'm just going to have to hold here and see what happens. But right now, I think I'd rather focus on the chance now that we have to get rid of Vicus Venedae, which has been a thorn in my side for a long time. It's been a source of Brutii power in and off. If we break Vicus Venedae, we break the Brutii again, and that leaves them now just kept relegated to the Black Sea coast, where we can finish them off once and for all. As they get squashed between Thrace, they get squashed between the Scythians, and they get squashed between my ever-growing borders. Right, as for you, diplomat, you need to get to Kersos, who is waiting for you to be talked to. So, let's see, where is the way across the river? It's way up here. Not a lot of river crossings in this area. I'm guessing these, like, really big rivers or something in real life, or, like, something like that, if there's no crossings, or these lands are just so uninhabited that no one really bothers to cross rivers. That's probably my more educated guess, but either way, just keep making your way around here, because it looks like the Brutii are preparing to make their final holdout at Tanais, which is going to be what it comes down to at the end of the day. But apart from that, we are once more at the end of a turn, so we are going to jump to the next turn. We're going to see what happens, and then we're going to see what we're going to do. But we are going to be very ready to attack Cyrene next, which is something to look forward to, and we're going to be ready to attack Dimindi. But I do want to call it an episode soon, because we are pretty much out of time. So I think we're going to attack Dimindi next turn, and then we'll deal with Domus and Vicus Venedae next turn, or we're going to get counterattacked and we'll be doing all of this now. But either way, let's not end the episode, but we'll end the turn first and see what's going to happen.
Disembark!
Right, nothing to report then. So the Brutii didn't counterattack as I was expecting them to. But it looks like the Scythians are on the move, so it might mean the Scythians might be starting to plan their first attack against the Brutii. So that will be something to look forward to, actually. It would be nice to see the Scythians pick up the slack in this war. So first things first, I'm just moving my diplomats since I had him selected already. Sadly, he's gone grey, which means his time is now running out. So we are going to have to try and make the most of him while we still have him. Don't really feel like talking to the Scythians right now, however. They don't do a lot for me. I'm hoping they do something, but apart from that, they just don't do anything. But I did get my spy kicked out of Phapsis, unfortunately, but I have a 100% chance just to walk right back in, so I'll just walk right back in if I don't mind if I do. Thank you, I'm back in here, and I know the garrison here is not too strong, so we are still in a good position to take it. It's just that Captain Flavius is right next to it. He does have a cavalry-heavy army, so I'm just gonna get rid of Dimindi and Nepta first, and then we've got Phapsis all on its own, and then I can just throw everything at it. End of turn report, by the way. Yeah, I'm still losing money, but I'm still very rich. City expands. Scalabis is now ready to expand. It's been a long time coming for Scalabis, so there you go. You get your proconsul's palace, you also get an academy, you also get a militia barracks, and a better port, so there you go. Enjoy your loot. Now, did someone else expand, maybe? Yeah, someone else. Ooh, Samara Breather, Yorick. Ooh, Samara Breather, you've had this one coming for a long time as well. You enjoy your imperial palace. You also get a dockyard, and crop rotation, and highways. Right, enjoy your loot. There you go. And also retrain these units here. There you go. I thank you, Tertius Maxentius, for your service to this town. Most of that, by the way, has gone to Egypt. What's more, we're just passing that title around like some sort of football. Looks like the Scipii, by the way, are having another go at Memphis. For looks like the Egyptians are sending their assassins to try and stop them. I think they might actually be successful. Oh, no, if I haven't. I was going to say, I'm sure there was a family member, but no, he's just made his way back to Siwa. So yeah, the Scipii are once more trying to attack Memphis. The Egyptians definitely don't want that to happen. Oh, Captain Ptolemy himself is actually trying to stop them, so that's pretty powerful for them. Faction announcements, by the way. Opius Maxentius sadly passed away. He was governor of Dava. Amulius Celo now has a spice merchant, and Opius Probus has a pet monkey, which gives him more to his agent skill. That's good for him. Now, construction report. Vicus Goffy, some irrigation. Sclabis, some highways. Cordubra has the better temple to Bacchus. Apollonia now has its urban barracks. Condate Redonum, the legion barracks, and we keep going down, and Tingi now also has its barracks, so there, all good stuff. Dava is in mourning, unfortunately. They're not happy over losing their governor, but they are also waiting on their better proconsul's palace to be done, so I'm going to wait on Dava. And meanwhile, I'm recruitment, auxilia from Lugnum, Levavum some auxilia, Capua some Praetorian cavalry, Vicus Goffi some early legion cavalry, Asturica some light auxilia, and then let's just keep scrolling down. Surta has also done a lot of retraining for us. Cool. Right, Capua, how are we doing with recruitment in Capua now? We're recruiting a lot of cavalry, aren't we? Yes, we are. We've got one unit of cavalry left to recruit for Caius Pompeius, and then we are going to be ready to go. Caius Pompeius also needs to be training, by the way. We're going to add some infantry to this army now, but I need this army moving quite soon, so it's just going to be legionary cohorts, so there you go. Have some legionary cohorts, I think that's enough. I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 units, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right, 6 units, there we go. Right, so there we go, that's the Capuan army ready to go. This army won't be hitting Africa, by the way. I'm going to have this one visit Greece, because I could use more. I think we do need a few more reinforcements in this area, because things are slowing down annoyingly, because we are just getting bogged down a little bit by the Brutii. But apart from this, I think we are moving quite quickly over here. Now, we are ready to make our move against Domus Dosis Domus and Vicus Venedae, but I do want to end this episode pretty much now, actually. Looks like the Scipii are going to focus their attacks on Paralysium again, though, so they are doing that. But before we do go, we're not going to leave this episode empty-handed. We're going to take Dimindi now, take another bit of Africa off the Scipii, because that's the territory I'd rather take today. So let's capture Dimindi, and then we can say, hey, I've got another Scipian territory, and then next time, my friends, we'll just help ourselves to Locus Gepidae once more. We're going to reconquer our lost land, and then we're going to also help ourselves to Pripet, and then we're going to start jumping down south. It's the beginning of the end for the Brutii now. I feel like we have now entered our final phase of our campaign. Taking these two territories will be key to once more breaking their strength. And now, then we go down to Scythia, we go down to Tribus Getae, we go down to Thrace, we go down to Propontis, and then we go down to Macedonia, and then we say, bye-bye, Brutii, you are gone. That's the plan. We're just about there now. But first things first, we are going to siege Dimindi. I have my sapping points ready to dig away at their walls. My cavalry is ready to charge into the town. Let's capture this town and see if it instills Roman values in it once more. So Captain Tiberius defends it with his 69 men, which is one unit of legionary cavalry. Shock horror, the Scipii brought a slightly stronger unit than usual. Who's going to get killed by all my Praetorian cohorts. I know my army is a little bit undernumbered, by the way. Remember, these guys are pretty battle-weary. They have been fighting a lot of battles in Tripolitania, and I've just been trying to find that place for them to pit stop. But we also do have early legionary cohorts who will just fall very easily. So strength ratio is 5 to 1 in my ratio. I have just about 500 men. He has 69 men. I outnumber him by a lot. I also have all my command stars. Let's just get into it, because the strength ratio is 5 to 1, and I think we could just win this one. We'll dig away at his walls, then we'll dig away at his morale, and then we'll dig away at his men, and then I'll just help myself to the city once more. But the blade itself incites to violence, said Homer. I guess it does. You see a blade, and then you suddenly start feeling violent. I guess that's just the way the world orbits.
Our enemies await! It would be rude to keep them waiting. So let us see how they like good Roman steel.
Those overly proud Romans over there are the Scipii. They think they are our equals, our enemies. I think they are dead men. They have been lulled into a false sense of security by a few feet of defensive wall, as if that will protect them. The count of our warriors will show you who is truly favored by the gods. It is not our foes. We are lacking in spearmen today,
and the many enemy horsemen may make life a little hectic if we are not careful. Many times I have faced this enemy, and many times I have beaten them. Today, when we win, this victory will be yours as much as mine. Only a fool cares for omens and portents, no matter how bad they may be. We make our own destinies, and we are not ruled by the flight of some damn bird. I have won many great victories for Rome. Be strong in that truth, and let this be one more. March on, and know that our victory is assured as long as we live and die like true Romans.
Right, I know you guys are weary, I know you guys need your rest, you've been marching in the desert, you've been fighting many a foe, but your time is nearly done, my friends. You are ready now to walk into here and get some rest and get some replenishment, but first things first, we need to just relieve this town of it from its owners. So, we don't really have the best entrance here, we are going to be attacking from this angle because the sapping points are pre-placed. So we do need to find access to the plaza from where we make our move. We do have access to the temple, it looks like, though, so... not really. Yeah, this city is not where it laid out. But by the way, that's the temple to Balhamon. That has to be destroyed. But yeah, we are going to have to just find a way. Most likely we're going to have to just take the long way around and find a rear entrance. But either way, I think we'll make our way in no matter what. So, how's it going to go? I'm going to have one bunch of units. The cavalry is going to come through this... breach here. They can run around and make their way to the back of the city very quickly and probably not take too much damage from tower fire. So I'll have one unit of auxilia here and they'll be digging this wall, and then on this wall here I'll have the early legionary cohorts dig this wall here, and then that's going to make room for all my infantry to march in. I do still have plenty of infantry left, so I do have my early legionary cohorts here. I do have my, well, they're not early ones. I'm getting very good at mixing everything up again, aren't I? I have my legionary cohorts there, I have my Praetorians bringing up the rear. My other legionary cohort, they can just stay here and they can match with their friends. Where's my other Praetorian? Right, all Praetorians, sorry. I ignored one of my Praetorians, that was not very good of me. Right, you guys just get here and then get yourselves organized, thank you very much. Right, and then, last but not least, cavalry. Cavalry, 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 cavalry. I know I don't have that much cavalry, but I'm still going to have it make it do its part. So, cavalry is going to just match through this breach. We can tank the Arrow fire and then I can use for their cavalry purposes. Libyan javelins, by the way. They can match with the infantry, but I doubt the Libyan... Actually, no. You know what? The Libyan javelins can just stay. I hire these mercenaries and then I don't use them. That's annoying for me. Like, I really should... I mean, they're good for field battles and on the defensive. I mean, they did okay in those battles. We need to get you guys a proper use, unfortunately. I think you guys are probably going to be hired just to be my garrison. I know you're probably not going to like it, but... Yeah, that's where I'm going to see you guys most useful. But even then, you're not going to be useful, because it's not like the Scipii are ever going to attack. And there isn't going to be some sort of big, evil barbarian that's going to rise in the east. Fuck, that ain't going to ever happen, right? Let's just get this one over and done with. 3-2-1, go, right? Let's capture Dimindi and put our feet up. So get in there, get digging. Now, you guys over there, get digging as well, please.
Go underground.
Right. We're going to dig those walls up and then we're going to make our way into the city. So cavalry will just pretty much, they're going to have to streak down here.
Soon the stones will mark enemy graves.
We could streak down this street with a cavalry, actually. Make our way to this wall here and then... make our way up to here, past the shit temple, and then down here. So I think that's going to be the strategy for us here, because there's only two approaches to the proconsul's palace, which is through this road here and through this road here. I would say this is probably shit city layout, by the way. This is not good city planning if there's only two ways to the government district. I know it's probably defensive and all that, but if I was living here, I'd just be getting annoyed all the time that I couldn't walk here, because I'd probably somehow get invisible walls from walking in these little alleys. I mean, look at this little alley here. This would be a perfect opportunity for an attack here. Like, I mean, look, you could... I wonder if I actually could sneak down this alley and attack. I mean, actually, is it possible to move? Let's see. I can move here. I can move here. Oh, come on! I'm not allowed to move through this alley. I mean, that's annoying. This alley is, like, the perfect opportunity. And I can't use it. I can't use it to attack this Scipii stupid fucking hell. If I had my way, I would be marching through the alley, because that'd be good urban combat. Use the alleyways. That way you can make your way through the city and past the barricades, but I guess we have to play fair. And a true Roman fights with honour. He doesn't fight like a dickhead. Right, anyway, we're making good progress on battering down these walls. I've already got my guys just digging their way through the soft sand on soft African grass. This is like the only slightly agricultural area, I guess, in the local area before we end up back in horrible deserts again in Africa. Big mountains over there, big amazing mountains. Actually, they look really cool in the sky, in like the skyline, background, horizon, whatever you want to say. They just look cool. But right, we're going to batter these walls down, and I'm going to have to fast forward because it would be cool if there were like enemies on the walls for us to batter down, but unfortunately it's just because it's standard issue procedure now because... we just don't have a good time fighting enemies. We just don't defend. I mean, I think Athens is going to be the only epic siege we're going to have in a while, actually, because we know Athens is... Actually, no, Vicus Venedae does have a lot of units, so yeah, we're going to look forward to sieging Vicus Venedae next episode, actually. That's going to be a fun battle. But there we go, one wall down, and another wall is down. Thank you. Right, cavalry, you have a job. Make your way to the plaza now. The wall is open. Legionaries, make your way to the plaza. The wall is open, and all the enemies are just piled up on the plaza. So all units just go to the plaza. It's simple as that, really. You can make your own way there. I'm gonna put enough faith in your pathfinding for you to do it, even though that is a really, really scary statement I've just said there. But I'm putting faith in the pathfinding of a game from about 2004. Yeah. Be very afraid. Be very, very, very afraid. But whatever. Right. They're just all going to do that. And now I'm just going to triple speed it until we get near the plaza. So enjoy. Enjoy, enjoy, enjoy. I'm actually going to keep an eye on the cavalry because they're the ones I'm just a little bit concerned about. But apart from that, yeah, they're having to match it nice and neat because that's how you enter a city now. You know, you don't bother about the towers raining fire upon you. Let's see. Which way are the cavalry going to take? Come on, cavalry. They are gonna go. They're gonna go up and around. All right, all right. I approve of that, but they are getting fired upon. Right, cavalry, double time it. Oh wait. Sorry, don't double time it. Don't double time it. I know where you're going now. I thought you were actually gonna go all the way around, but no, you're gonna go past here, past the alley, which we could have used. And then we're just gonna. Yeah, I see where we're going. All right. And infantry, they're just doing the same thing, so right. I'll just let everyone make their way to at least the temple, and then we'll deal with the enemy, because right now, they're not in the mood to do anything, so why should I have to do anything, because... Yeah. Scipio just aren't committed to this war at all. I think they just know they've lost, so they've just basically given up. They could have just surrendered and handed all their territory over diplomatically if they wanted. I wouldn't have minded. It would have saved me a lot of time and a lot of paperwork. Right, slow down. Whoa. When did I give you permission to double time it again? I thought I told you to undouble time it. You're gonna... It's alright, the enemy don't care. Well, actually, no, the legionaries care. Right, you know what? I've got an idea. We'll lure those legionaries. Right, cavalry, retreat a little bit, and it didn't work. I was gonna lure them into the streets where I could surround and kill them easy. Oh, well. It was worth a try. Right, cavalry, you just organise yourselves up here and then just wait for the infantry to catch up because we are just waiting on them. They should be nearby now, actually. Let's just see where they are. They're somewhere. Infantry. Oh, wait. Oh, come on, infantry. Speed it up. Come on. Pick up the pace. But we're all... Guys, don't run there. Guys, don't run. Infantry. Oh, for fuck's sake. Infantry, don't run. Look at you, you're taking out all your stupid stamina. Don't run to the battle, walk to the battle. We don't want to fight them tired. Right. Make your way there in a nice, orderly fashion. Do not run, because if you get to the battle tired, you're not gonna put in your best performance. You're going to die, aren't you? Stupid sodding units. Right, just get marching at a nice, orderly pace. Yes, you are going to get fired up by the towers, I know, but it's something you're just going to have to accept. You're just going to have to keep your shield facing the tower and hope that it just pings off your shield or something. Because I'm not having you all match in Test Tudor, by the way, because that would take ages. But right, infantry is now making its way over. Right, legionary cohorts, where are we at with legionary cohorts? They're somewhere, yeah. Oh, my units, I think I'm just marching in a bit of a mishmash formation, as in they've just marched us however they fucking want because my units are stupid fucking useless idiots. I should stop smack talking these guys who have fought so many battles, shouldn't I? But yeah, right, no, wait, sorry, I nearly gave a push to double time. Actually, I was just going to hit the triple speed button, right. Triple speed, just so we can get you marching into the plaza and then get you starting to do it. Because you know what, any of you units will win anyway, because we are fighting a very weak army. The legionary cavalry is the only slightly threatening unit there, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get you guys engaged and I'll slam my cavalry right into the back. My general's bodyguard should be able to kill them quite comfortably, but right. Focus on the early legionary corps who have noticed you and they are now marching towards you. Cavalry, let's get you back into this game now, now that the legionary cavalry has seen its prey and is making its way forward. So now everyone has their purpose. Praetorian cohorts are throwing themselves into battle. They're already winded because these idiots decided to run half a distance because they're absolute fucking idiots. But what do I know? And oh, damn it. The cavalry just got right in there. And that's already shaking up my morale. Right. So, all right. My general's here. Never fear. The general's here. He's going to help you out, guys. Don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry. And ah, yes. Look at that. That's already bringing their morale up. Now that the general's nearby, they're happy. Right. All units, are you guys gonna help, or are you just gonna stand there and observe? Get in there and help your guys. I know you all need a homeland and you're all just sitting there, you know, no one's gonna bring your new city to you. You have to fight for it. Cavalry, pull out, get ready for the next charge while my infantry takes over the fighting for a little bit. Oh, my cavalry's pulling out and oh, we're pulling the cavalry away. Perfect, right. You guys have fun taking out the infantry. I've got the cavalry isolated and away from the infantry now. That's what I wanted. Right, go on. Get in there and kill them. Roman cavalry, you pull out because you're going to get fucked up because you're useless and shit. Roman cavalry, you attack the early legionary corps, actually. General, you can finish off the legionary cavalry. Oh, wait, legionary cavalry all died. Oh, well, perfect. Kill the captain then. May as well just make it official and see that he's properly dead. Perfect. Good.
The enemy general is slain, and now his men fear us. It is time to press the attack!
Right, go for the finishing moves then. Just a few units to go. This has gone perfect for me now, so... Yep. Everyone's dead again. Thank you, guys. You guys got a little bit too eager, though, to get yourselves a new home city with your running and your disorganisedness, but at least at the end of the day, you got the job done. So this time, the means will justify at the end, but be a bit more careful next time. Skippy-eye, when you're building a city... First things first, Roman temple over a stupid shit temple, and then please plan your cities better. This was horrible to march through. And also, game, let me choose where I put my sapping points. It would be easier for me. But, oh well, whatever, whatever. We can all moan, but at least we still win the battle and win the town. So, there are some stats. Not really much of a battle again. I killed everything. I didn't really take that many losses. And now we can settle down, retrain. Aleacta S. The die is cast. The die isn't really cast. It's more like the Skippy I are dead. So, that's the main important thing. So, I will take Domindi over now. Thank you very much. And now, next thing's next, we will make our way to Nepta. I know there's a Roman family member here. At least Caeso Pompilius. One of the few Skippy I generals remaining. He's running around. There are a few rebels to take out, but right. Let's occupy the place. We need the support of a town in order to make my plans work. So first it says repair and retrain. That's the most important thing. We need to repair and retrain, and then we need to rebuild. Build the Imperial Palace. It looks like these people were waiting for one, so get that done. We'll get the repair walls repaired. We'll cut the taxes as well, make the races daily. There we go. The people will be happy. Also get them more food. People need food. What are we thinking about? Not feeding the people. I'm also upgrading the barracks as well, right. There we go, that's everything we need in Domindi to quickly upgrade, and then we'll move to Nepta once this army's repaired. But we're also going to get ready to leave Sirta soon and leave Carthage soon. So Phapsis is now pretty much isolated, and Africa is pretty much under my control. Very, very quickly as well at that as well, because we're Skippy, I aren't very good at trying. But that is where we're going to call it an episode. So we have suffered setbacks at Athens, unfortunately. But that was the last episode, I think. But we do have other good things happening for us. We do have now sieges at Vicus Venedae and Domestilsis Domus to fight. So two more territories are about to fall. Then I may have to hold them against the Brutii, but I think we can hold anything against the Brutii. Because they do keep trying to siege us, but then they just run off because the Brutii are cowards. At the end of the day, they're not fighters. They're just effeminate Greeks. That's all they are. So it's a shame for them. They should have stuck to the Roman culture and not betrayed me for the effeminate, wimpy, wimpy, wimpus, philosophical, narco, Greco culture. They should have stuck with a good, hard, manly Roman culture. But that's their problem, and it just leaves me with an excuse to wipe them all out and X them and build my Roman Empire on top of them. So, whatever. I still gain something out of this at the end of the day. But that is where we're going to call it an episode, my friends. So I hope you've enjoyed, and I look forward to seeing you on the next one. Goodbye.